Hey, Vicki Sicliano here from SayWowMarketing.com. So I'm going to show you in this video today how you can save hundreds of dollars and design your very own print book cover, just like this, using a free online tool called Canva. Okay, I'm going to show you the 12 steps that you need to do. Did it myself for my book, and I'm going to walk you through those 12 steps. We're going to go inside, and if you stick with me to the end of the video, I'm going to show you how you can snag some free content from this book on visual marketing secrets. Okay, so nothing to be scared of. I'm going to show you how. Stay tuned. Okay, for your print book cover, the first thing that you want to do is download a template. So I used Createspace for my print book, and it's fantastic. So it's owned by Amazon, and they integrate with it. I'm going to show you in a second how. So you're going to download a book template from Createspace. And the easiest way to do this is just to go to book template and just do a search. Okay, I already did it for you here. So you download it as a PNG template or a PDF. I downloaded it as a PNG template, and then I uploaded it to Canva. Then I'm going to show you where it is on Canva. Okay, so I created a space. I uploaded the print cover template, so now I have this template to build on, okay? And the next thing that you have to do, okay, step three, is to design a front cover and a back cover. Now, I have another video that you can check out to show you how you can design that. There's a template that's already in Canva's homepage. Check out my other video on that. But for this template, for the front and the back, I created a 2020 by 4500 canvas. Okay, so here's the front book cover. Okay, so that's what that looks like. Okay, so I created a folder for my print cover elements, and that is simply the front and the back cover. So there we've got my front cover and all of these individual elements that I built to become my print cover and my Kindle cover. See, I can click on each of those individually if I ever needed to change a font, to change text spacing, colors, whatever it is. Okay, so that's my front cover. Then you have the back cover. Okay, and you're going to be mostly moving the back cover around just to make sure that you're going to be within your template limits and to leave a space enough for your ISBN number. Okay, so let me go home. Okay, so let's go to the template for the book cover, and I'm going to show you how this all works together. So basically, you have a front cover, you have a back cover, and you also have a spine. But because my print cover has 148 pages and it's a relatively thin book, it had a 0.34 inch spine. So it was easier for me to create all of these spine elements directly on this template. So if I needed to adjust anything, I could move each individual piece, you know, over. Okay, so that's how I did it. I created a separate piece for the spine. Here's the back cover. Now, once I create the back cover, I export it, save it as an image on my computer, and then I upload it again. So it sits in my uploads. Then I paste it here in this template. Okay, so the most important thing to know about using your book cover template is this transparency. Okay, I usually switch it on to 40. That's what worked perfectly for me. So I could see in the background the orange bar that I had to stay within, and also the barcode location, so that my barcode came out perfectly. It didn't stand over any text. My face was in a perfect location because before I had to keep modifying the image in my design, in my other design folder, because I was like out of the box and it wouldn't look good for print. So you just keep making them, you know, transparent. You're happy with it. Then you save that image and you export it. If you're not, you're going to have to keep modifying it in your other folder, and then you're going to just upload it again and see if you're within this limit. So you always play with this transparency. You upload it, you make sure that it fits by changing the transparency. Once it is set, then you flip the transparency back to 100%. Then the next step is that you're going to print it out, okay? So you export this, you download it. Okay, I'm not gonna show you how to download, but you download this image. Then when you have the image on your computer, you crop it and then you print it, because otherwise when you print, you're gonna be printing this small image on a page that is like this wide. And I think this image is 13 inches wide. So it makes it a lot easier for you to see if it's going to work for you. You're gonna see if you like the way the fonts look, if everything is crisp, if you need to change anything, always print it out. Okay, then when you're fully satisfied, you export it. It's going to export as a PNG file, and then you just convert it to a JPEG or a PDF, whatever CreateSpace is looking for. I believe I converted it to a JPEG. Then you upload it to CreateSpace. Then you're going to wait for this approval process with the suggestions that they give you, order approve, and then if you're happy, then you just order more copies. But the beautiful thing is when it's on Amazon, you have your book cover already uploaded, all of the information there. And here, I'm going to show you this really cool thing. So here's the front. And here's the back. All of this was designed in Canva pretty easily. And you just need to know how to use the tools. But they're all there for you. And it really democratizes all the tools of production for us all. So I saved hundreds of dollars on a designer. I completely thought that I was going to need to hire a designer, but I ended up saving the money that I could have used on a designer, and I just ordered more books. So that was awesome. And there you have it. There's your print book cover. Showed you how to use the template on Canva. And check out my other video that shows you how to create the Kindle book cover if you need that. And I hope I answered your questions. If you have any more, please post them for me below this video. Thanks for watching.